Wing Chun is based on concepts and principles that guide us rather than following straight technique only. To learn these concepts, we practice our forms. We start by learning the Sealum Tao, which teaches us our foundational concepts, principles, and movements. It is often said that learning Sealum Tao is like learning the alphabet. Each section of form and each movement teaches us a concept like elbow positioning, centerline control, and efficiency. We are also building our foundation as we do our entire form in our version of the horse stance, or Yi Ji Kim Yong Bang, which makes our legs nice and strong. Wing Chun is a Shaolin martial art that traces its roots to the Southern Shaolin Temple. Developed by a nun, Wing Chun emphasizes structure and positioning over size and strength. Composed of elements from both snake style and crane style kung fu, Wing Chun relies on defensive movements that emphasize deflecting rather than blocking, and rapid, precise offensive attacks. Wing Chun was first brought to prominence by its most famous practitioner, the late great Bruce Lee, who was also born in San Francisco. Thank you, Dave, Robert, Tony. If Sealum Tao is learning the alphabet, then Chun Kung Fu is learning how to put those letters and words into phrases. Chun Kung Fu teaches us mobility, how to effectively make contact with the opponent, and how to combine our individual Sealum Tao movements into complete techniques. It's like going from writing words to writing an essay. This is where we put those first four movements together into something nice and cohesive. Chun Kung Fu also teaches us new concepts like jamming, kicking, and shifting. Thank you, Jennifer, Hondo, and Denver. The Bat Jam Dao, or butterfly swords, are the short double weapons form of Wing Chun. The Bat Jam Dao is comprised of stabs, slashes, as well as blocks and deflections. In the Wing Chun system, we only have three empty hand forms, two weapon forms, and the famous wooden dummy form, making this a relatively simple system to learn, but at the same time, a very complex system to fully comprehend. Let's give it up for Hondo, demonstrating three forms in a row for you. Next, what to do if someone grabs one of your arms. The ladies are using the joint energy release from the third form. Lastly, the ladies will show how to break the grip if someone grabs you cross-handed. They're using the end of the first form to break the grip. Now, for a little bit of audience participation, if you'd like to